Now student, a circuit diagram of potentiometer is given and I am reading the question. Listen carefully. A battery E1 of 4 volt, and a variable resistance RH, are connected in series with a wire AB, of the potentiometer. The length of the wire of potentiometer is 1 meter. The length of the wire potentiometer is 1 meter means 100 centimeter. When a cell of E2 of EMF 1.5 volt is connected between point A and C, a cell of EMF whose value is 1.5 connected between A and C, and listen carefully, no current flow through E2. When cell E2 is equal to 1.5 volt connected in between A and C, no current flow through E2. Length AC equal to 60 centimeter. And we have to find the, find the potential difference between the ends A and B. And second question. Put the method work if the battery E1 is replaced by a cell of EMF of 1 volt. In place of 4 volt, it changed to 1 volt, then the method work or not. So first of all student, one thing should be remembered that in case of a potentiometer, there will be important point is that null point is obtained on the potentiometer wire only if the battery voltage must be greater than EMF of the cell to be measured. It means the auxiliary circuit or driving voltage, that is what, if battery voltage is greater than the EMF of the cell to be measured, then null point will be obtained on the potentiometer wire. Otherwise null point will not be obtained on the potentiometer wire. And if battery voltage is less than the EMF of the cell to be measured, then null point will not be obtained on the potentiometer wire. Another point, both battery voltage and the EMF of the cell to be measured, whether one cell or two cells, their positive terminal must be connected to point A or zero end. It means what? The battery, positive terminal of battery and the EMF of the cell to be measured, their positive terminal must be connected to point A. So now I am going to solve this question. Find the potential difference between the ends A and B. And student, according to question, when cell E2 whose EMF is 1.5 volt connected between A and C, no current flow through it. It means what? Galvanometer shows no deflection. It means potential at this point and potential at this point. That is what? Same. So there will be no flow of current through a galvanometer. And this point and this point and this point is what? Also connected with what? Resistance less wire. So potential at this and potential at this. That is what? Same. It means what? Potential difference across this AC, which is equal to EMF of the cell, and at null point no current is drawn by the cell, and you know that V equal to what? E minus IR. You know that when I equal to what? Zero. When no current is drawn from the cell, it means what? V equal to what? E. You know that. So student, when V equal to E, it means potential difference across AC must be equal to EMF of the cell. And student, if K is the potential gradient along the length of wire AB, so when E equal to V, so at null point E2, cell E2, which is equal to what? Potential difference across wire AC, and you know that V is equal to K equal to what? V equal to KL. You know that potential gradient, potential per unit length. So V is AC can be written as what? K is the potential gradient along the AB length of the wire, and VAC equal to K, and balancing length comes out to be the student at 60 centimeter from end A. So AC, that is what, 60 centimeter, and E2 which is given 1.5 volt, and K which is we have to find out, and L1 student, that is what, 60 centimeter. So L1 comes out to be that 15 by 600. Solving this 15 by 6. So that is what? 1 by 40. 1 by 40 volt per centimeter. This is the balancing length. This is the potential gradient. And we have to find the potential difference between in A and B. And student, you know that VAB equal to what? VAB equal to KL. What is potential gradient, student? Potential gradient, that is what? D equal to what? Potential gradient K equal to what? V by L. And V, that is what? Potential drop per unit length of the wire. And we have to find potential drop means what? Potential difference across AB. And per unit length means what? 100 centimeter length of the wire. And if we have to write this equation, B equal to KL. So we have right here VAB. We have to find potential difference across AB. Potential gradient remains same. Length become what? 100 centimeter, because we are finding the potential difference of potentiometer wire of 1 meter length, that is for 100 centimeter. So VAB we have to find, which is equal to KL, and here K already we have calculated, that is what, 1 by 40 volt per centimeter, and L, that is your student, that is what, 100 centimeter. So this will be cancelled out, 2 and 5. So VAB 5 by 2, which is equal to a 2.5 volt. So this is the potential difference, that is what, 2.5 volt. So first answer is that potential difference between in A and B, which comes out to be the 2.5 volt. And second question, student, this is very important for the concept of the potentiometer. Would the method work if the battery even is replaced by a cell of EMF of 1 volt? So student, when 4 volt battery is replaced by what? 1 volt. Already I have explained to you that if battery voltage, if E1 is less than E2, it means what? When battery voltage is replaced 4 volt to 1 volt, so battery voltage is less than the EMF of the cell to be measured, then what will be happen? If battery voltage, that is 1 volt, less than the EMF of the cell, that is what, 1.5 volt, then null point will not be obtained on the potentiometer wire. So the method, would the method work? No, this method will not be work, because because battery voltage is less than the EMF of the cell E2, so null point will not be obtained, so method will not be work.